So now we'll do an easy exercise. We have a charge, a concentrate charge, just in the middle of this beam. So it's we have to make a cut here and another cut here and see what happens. So first, we'll draw the forces on the supports. This one is vertical, and this one is vertical, UB. This is HB, and this is BA. So, doing the sum of all the forces in the horizontal direction and the all the beam, as there are any horizontal forces, we know that HB equals 0. Okay, and we also could write that BB plus BA has to equal P, and because of the symmetry, in this case we can know that both of them equals P halves, and this one also P halves, but that's just because of the symmetry of the problem, otherwise we'll have to do another thing. So here, this is our cut, our first cut. So here we have BA, here we have B, their serine stress, and as we have taken this reference of system, this is the positive x direction and this is the positive y direction, if we take it here, this distance is x. So this is the moment, the bending moment. Okay, and we will have also the normal. Okay, now we have to plant the equilibrium equation for this case. So, as there are any forces on the horizontal direction, we know that N equals 0. We know that BA has to equal B, so B is equal to P halves. This is the first important result. And this, when we are taking torque, we have also to take torque with respect that of the point that it's on the side of the where we just cut it. So in this case, this is the cut, so here is the point that we have to take from the torques. So, we take the sense of torques positive, so M equals this distance, X, BA, so it's negative, so M has to be equal to BA times X, so we can conclude that M equals P halves of X. And, okay, how can we know that this is correct? Can you remember in the previous video what were the equations? The derivative of the bending moment with respect to X was the serine force. And what do we have here? That if we take the derivative with respect of X of this one, we obtain the serine stress, so we can check that it's correct. Okay, now we have to take this other place, we'll do it here. We take this other part of the beam, so here we have BB. And now the forces, as we know, we have to invert the sense of them. So this is B, and now the bending moment is in this direction. Okay, and the normal is in this direction. Okay, and now what is this length? How can we know it? Okay, so if all the beam measures L, this piece of beam is X, whatever it is. So this would be L minus X, because L, o sea, X is the distance that we have taken. I don't know. So, for example, here, this is L. If whatever we have taken is L, L minus X is this distance. Okay, this is our point of reference of torques. Okay, so now, N, okay, N equals 0. Now, B equals minus BB, the sum of the forces on, remember, the equilibrium equation on the y direction has to be 0. So from here, we know that B equals minus B halves, and now the torques. Okay, we have this sense of positive direction, so L minus X times BB has to be equal in the negative, and now those are negative torque. So M equals L minus X times BB, and we have BB equals B halves. So M equals L minus X times B halves. So now we're going to explain how to do a diagram. These were the results that we have just obtained. So here we will do the cold bending moment and shearing stress diagram. Okay, this is B and this is M. Okay, this is the length. So this will be 0, L halves, L halves, L, and 0. Okay, what happens when L equals 0? Sorry, here, B, what happens when it equals 0? The shearing stress is equals to B over 2. But this is till we reach B, then it changes to minus B halves. So it will be here, minus B halves. So we have a discontinuous function that will be something like this. In this point we have a discontinuity because we have a charge applied on that point. And now, what happens to the moment? It's pi over 2 of x. Okay, so what happens when x equals L halves? We have here, if we multiply p over 2 of x, where x equals L halves, we obtain PL over 4, that it's the maximum value of the torque, and as we know, this is a straight line, so it would be something like this. And now, L minus X. What happens when L X equals L in this other part of the beam? L minus L equals 0, so here the moment is 0, and as we know, this is also a straight line, we have something like this. Okay, so what does this mean? We know that here we can summarize that when we are applying a concentrated charge on a point, we have a discontinuity on the shearing stress, and we have a instantaneous abrupt change on the slope of the line. So it's clear that here it's discontinuity, and here it changed suddenly the slope. I am Vanessa. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye!